people are hard-headed. We hard-headed. We say we want change. We cry when we get gunned down. We cry when we get oppressed. We scream, we march, we talk about it, but we don't do anything. Sister in the blue, what's your name, sis? All praises, sis. Come get this word today. This for you, sis. All right, sis, come talk to me. Read that real quick.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 8, verse 11.
Read.
Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily.
So we walk around our entire lives in the midst of sin. Our entire lives in the midst of sin. But because the Most High doesn't judge us speedily, read.
Therefore, the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil.
That's why we think we can get away. That's why you sit up there and sleep with 100 women and think you'll get away with it. Right. That's why you sit up there and rob your brother or kill your brother 100 times and think you got away with it. Because the Most High doesn't judge you. But the Most High has compassion on his people. He's merciful to his people. That's why he's giving you time to get your life right. But we don't want to get our life right. Go to, read that again.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 8, verse 11.
Read.
Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily. Therefore, the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil.
We fully set our minds to commit wickedness. We are destroying people, man. Most of us not even gonna realize that there is a God until we're in the midst of judgment. Right. That's for real. And I'm talking to y'all over there. Come talk to me, because this is the most important thing you're about to get in your life. The right. most important thing you're about to get in your life.
Right.
Go to, give me, you know what I want to say, get that for me real quick. The only time we're going to start to realize that we need to get back to serving God is when the Most High start putting trials on us. We start feeling some burn. For those who got children, the only time that your children listen to you is when you say something like you want to go get a belt. Or you start putting fire on their tail. Hey, brothers, come talk to me. What's your name, man? What's your name?
Stacks.
What's your name?
Stacks.
My name's Yosef. Come talk to me real quick, man. You ever heard you're an Israelite?
Yeah.
You heard it? All praises. So tell me what you know about being an Israelite, bro.
Well, you tell the truth.
That's right.
I see dudes online talking shit. They be like, white bitch, come here.
Okay, yeah, we're not like that, bro. We don't need to do that. You know what we out here to do? What we out here to teach? That our people are the biblical Jews according to the Bible.
That's
give me
right.
Deuteronomy 7 and 6. What's your name again? I'm sorry.
Stacks.
What's your name? Chet. Stacks.
Deuce.
I'm sorry?
Deuce.
Yos?
Deuce.
Deuce.
Deuce. All right, Deuce. Chet.
Champ.
Champ.
Stacks.
All right, my name is Yosef, right? This is what the Most High God says about you. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy. Chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God have chosen thee to be a special people.
So the Most High God chose the so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native American man and women to be a special people. And we're gonna prove that. Because too many times we've been told we niggas, we the bottom of society, we good for nothing, we murderers, super predators, and all manner of things. But God says we are holy people unto him.
Well,
read.
Hold on.
We're going to finish this and I'm going to get your question, bro. Read.
Unto himself,
uh-huh.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
And contrary to what you believe, we ain't equal with nobody neither. We always told that we're equal. We all equal. No, but they show you by how they treat you. We all not equal. But God says we're not equal.
You're better than them.
You're better than them. You're better than them. But guess what? We don't carry ourselves like we're better than the people that oppress us. We carry ourselves, we treat ourselves lower than worse than they treat us. You believe that? What's your question, man? I want
to. Well, I actually had a statement.
Now, you ain't out here to make statements, brother. This is our form. You got a question, we'll ask your question. You know, we'll ask you a question, but if you got a statement, hold your statement.
I had a statement with something that you said.
Okay, all right, what's up,
bro? Going off the Bible, right?
Right.
That book only 8,000 years old. Our people been around way longer than that.
That's not true, brother. This word is. Go to, what was it?
Man, that book is 8,000 years old, man. Our people are way older than that. So how's that our truth?
Psalm 68 and 11, right? This book has been around longer than we exist. And I'm going to prove it.
Because
you're saying this book was written by a man. Am I correct?
Of course.
Okay, so could a man prophesy something thousands of years before it happened and it come to pass? Can a mere man do that?
Man, I can say something right now and it can happen 4 years later and I can say I prophesied.
Can I say tomorrow? tomorrow you're gonna walk down the street and a blue truck is gonna come by and roll over your big toe. And it happens that way. Can that happen? Can a mere mortal do that? That's not something random or chance, that's specific.
I don't know no situation in the Bible where that has happened.
I'm about to show you, right? Read that real quick though, because this ain't no man's book. This is the word of the Most High God, and we're gonna prove that.
That's right. The book of Psalms, chapter 68, verse 11. The Lord gave the word.
So the Most High gave the word, right? But did the Most High come down and talk to us? We ain't even worthy of that. The Most High deal with us, we gonna get put to death. Believe that. Read.
Great was the company of those that published it.
So in any case with a book, it has to be published. The scriptures say great was the company who published it. Meaning God, the Spirit of God came upon these men. These men wrote these words down for a witness for our people. Because our people will go through the things written in this book. Give me Deuteronomy the 28th chapter. Now I'm gonna show you, according to this Bible, things that befell your people that no man can prophesy.
That's right.
Because we get, you know who taught you that this is a man's book? That so-called, where's that sign at? That man right there, that our people believe in. That so-called white man that taught you everything, all praises. You believe that. But that's where all of your wisdom and understanding comes from. The people that oppress you taught you this is a man's book. And you know why they taught you that? To hide it from you.
Right.
Your history is in this book.
Right.
But guess what? Our people have been destroyed so much with this book that now when someone tells you, you're the gods of this book, you're the priests and kings of this book, you're the greatest people on the book, we don't want to hear it. Because all we'd have been taught was white people in this book. That's what Jesus looked like. The Jews are Caucasian. I ain't nothing.
Bring it up.
I'm just on the bottom. So we believe this. But watch this. Deuteronomy 28, 15. Listen up, man. Listen real close. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Hey, come closer, man. So there was a stipulation in the Bible that was happening after the children of Israel came out of slavery to the Egyptians. God told Moses to tell them, if you do what this Bible says, keep my commandments, you'll be above all people on the face of the earth. You'll be better, you'll be priests and kings, royalty. But if you don't do what I tell you to do, then you're gonna be cursed, right? So let's get some curses. Read the next one. Listen carefully to these curses. And you tell me if a man can make this up and it happened the way it happened.
Read that book about 5 or 6 times, bro.
Give me 16 real quick.
Yes, sir.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 16. Cursed shall thou be in the city.
Stop right there. So in any city you go.
Hold on, brother.
It's Alva. We got it, bro. Trust me, bro, we got it, right? So in the city, when you look around the city, we're in the city right now, right? Look at this, say to your people. Look at this, say to your people. Look at the people across the street. Look at anybody you see out here. What's the state of our people in the city? Do we look like we are blessed people, or do we look like we are in a cursed people?
Bring it up. Bring it up.
Somewhere in the middle.
Somewhere in the middle? So I'm subject to grow up in a house with my mother, but my father's not there. That's in the middle.
Bring it
or I'm subject to grow up in a community where people are selling drugs to my own people.
Bring it up.
Killing my own people. That's somewhere in the middle. Or I'm subject to grow up to where my sister is more likely to grow up and be somebody's baby mother rather than wife. That's in the middle.
Bring
that's
it up.
Cursed, brother.
Bring it
that's
up.
Not in these other communities. They marry their daughters off to men. Those men take care of those women.
That's right.
They raise up children to those wives.
Right.
And take care of their families. They don't sell drugs to their own people. They sell drugs to you. They'll sell drugs to you. They don't kill their own people. We kill our own people. They kill us. So that's not in the middle. That's on the bottom. We get the
God. We fear the power of a dollar right now.
You're right. We fear everything but the Most High God, right? We do. But that's because we don't have no understanding, bro.
Right.
We don't have no... Hosea 4:4-6. Get that real quick. That's because we've been taught by the wrong people. That's because we've been taught by the wrong people. And we're going to show you that according to the Bible. The brother touched on some heavy things and about how because about disobedience, you know, and not keeping the laws, we went into sin. We went into slavery and things like that, right? So read this real quick, and then we're going to touch on it. Read.
The book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6.
This is why we don't fear anything, right? We don't fear God. Read.
My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
So scriptures say our people, God's people, are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
The knowledge is the scriptures, the Bible, and we're going to show you that. We reject it with this Bible, say we wouldn't do it.
If you reject my knowledge, I'm not dealing with you neither. Though.
Exactly, like your parents, right? Like if your parents say, don't go across the street after a certain hour or you're going to be on punishment. Yeah. That's her knowledge, that's her wisdom. If you reject that, you get the consequences, right? It's the same principle with the Most High. Same, we his sons, we his children. So if we don't listen to our Father, there's consequences. Read.
That thou shall be no more priest to me.
Why?
Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God.
Forgotten what?
The law of thy God.
That's the knowledge. So because we forgot the laws of our God, he rejected us because we rejected him first. Matthew 11 and 6. Now I'm going to show you something. We're going to touch on some things, right? Because the brother went into our oppression, the things that happened to us as a result of breaking these commandments, right? But I want to establish something first, because this ain't no weak book. This book is meant to check you and change you. And it's not going to be always comely. It's not going to be always pretty. It's going to hurt sometimes.
What they call it, basic
instructions before leaving earth, right? These instructions going to hurt a little bit. It's going to sting. We're going to get you right, but I'll read that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 6. And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me.
So Christ said, while he was correcting his people, blessed is he who is not offended in me, right? Blessed is he who is not offended in me, right? Give me 1 Corinthians 6 and 9, right? We're going to touch on some things. We're going to deal with some things, right? Because in order to get back to the Most High God, our Father, we got to change ourselves. We got to fix what's wrong with us, right? We got to get corrected, right? Matter of fact,
is this an actual like newspaper clipping from
right,
back in the day?
Right, this is all real things. These are all real images, right? Hold that real quick. Give me Leviticus 19:17 first, right? So we're going to show you that this correction is not always coming. It's not always pleasant, but it's love nonetheless. If I let you walk around in the condition that you're in and I say nothing, I hate you according to the Bible, but you my brother, right? So if I love you, I'm going to do this. Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 17, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
That's a law. I shouldn't hate my brother in my heart, meaning my mind. When I see my brother and when I think on my brother, the first thing that should come to my mind is not hatred, right? Read.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
What should you do?
Rebuke thy neighbor.
Rebuke is just correction. So if I see you in a state that's not according to this, I must correct you as my brother if I love you. And if I hate you,
that's what you're saying. Rebuke means a correction.
It means correction.
I thought rebuke mean like I ain't even supposed to fuck with them over there.
That means correction. If I rebuke you or correct you on something, I'm telling you, hey, bro, you stealing? Don't do that. That's wrong. That's rebuke, right? If I love you, right? Read.
And not suffer sin upon him.
Because sin is the breaking of these laws, right? Now the scripture said, blessed is he who is not offended in me, right? So this is the correction, and I want you to tell me what this means. Read that.
1 Corinthians 6 and 9.
Yes, sir. 1 Corinthians 6 and 9, right? Read that. Read that real quick.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 6, verse 9.
Read.
Now ye know ye not that the unrighteousness shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
So the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God, right?
But they got it now. They got Israel now.
They're not the kingdom of God. We're the kingdom of God. And what's prepared for us is the kingdom of God. See, their faith.
That's one of the first things.
Get Luke 21. Hold that. Luke 21. We're going to show you. We're the kingdom of God. So regardless of what you see the other nations doing, this is their kingdom. All this is going to die and burn.
And our children too. We have a banker. We have a banker. I'm a Jew, it's our art. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more, it's our art, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.